Welcome to the 27th lecture on computational mathematics with Sage Math. In this lecture, we will look at an application of local maximum, local minimum to least square problems. So, in last lecture, we saw how to find local maximum and local minimum of a function, and in this lecture, we will look at one of its application. It has many applications. We will look at one such. This problem is called regression analysis problem in statistics, or this is also known as best fit problems. So let us look at what it is. So first let us look at, suppose you have a set of points in the plane and you want to fit the best fit straight line to this set of points. For example, you can think of this as a real life problem. Suppose these are set of villages in some area and the government wants to build a railway track. Now railway track will be straight, so the government wants to build a railway track so that these villagers are not unhappy. So they will have to find out what is the best possible way in which this railway track can be built, right? Now what do you mean by, first of all, building the best fit railway track or finding the best fit straight line to this given set of points? So suppose this is the straight line, which is the best fit straight line, and let us say its equation is y equal to mx plus c, where m is the slope and c is the intercept. Now then what the meaning of this best fit straight line? One way to define is that look at its distance from all of these points. So let us suppose this is a point xi yi, and look at the vertical distance of this point from this straight line. So if I look at this, if this point is xi yi, this somewhere here it will be xi, and this point somewhere here, this will be y coordinate of this will be mxi plus c. So you look at the difference between the y coordinate, that is yi minus mxi minus c, that is the distance, but this could be a negative. For example, if I look at this point which is below the straight line, this yi minus mxi minus c will be negative. So but the distance is positive, so you can look at the absolute value of this distance, that is the vertical distance of xi yi, and then you want to minimize this distance for each of this point. Now this modulus is not a differentiable function, so you can take the square of this distance, that will be yi minus mxi minus c the whole square, and this you want to minimize for every I. That means you can take the sum of the squares of the distance and then minimize that. So this distance you can think of as an error term, because this is the best possible the straight line would have been when all these points are on this straight line. So that's the ideal situation, but that is not the case. So the vertical distance will be the error. So what you need to do is you need to find AB, or let us say M and C, the slope and intercept, for which the sum of the squares of the distance of this straight line from all these points is minimum, is same as saying. Now you can formulate this problem as follows. So suppose you are given xi yi, I going from 1 to n, the n set of points in the plane, and then what we want to do, we want to find the best fit straight line y equal to mx plus c to the given set of points. This amounts to finding m and c, which minimizes this function f of mc, which is sum of yi minus mxi minus c the whole square. This is sum of the error square, okay? So this is what you want to minimize, this is right. So that is the best fit problem or least square problem of, this is a linear least square problem, okay? Now you can also do the same thing. Suppose you want, instead of straight line, you wanted to fit a parabola, let us say y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. So in that case, again you can find the vertical distance, square of the vertical distance, take the sum of the squares of the vertical distance, and that sum of the squares of the vertical distance will be function of three variables now, a, b and c. So you try to minimize this. So how do we formulate? In this case, the formulation will be, suppose you are given this set of points, n points, and you want to fit this parabola y equal to ax square plus bx plus c. The vertical distance will be of the point I will be yi minus axi square minus bxi minus c, and then take the square of this, take the sum, that is a function of abc. So, you want to find abc which minimizes this function. So, that is a minimization problem, and this is actually a quadratic, so it will have just only one minimum, which will be a global minimum, right. So, let us take an example. So, suppose you want to look at first fitting the best fit straight line y equal to mx plus c to a given set of points. So, suppose you are given this set of points, let me first plot its graph, the set of points. So, these are the set of points, it is the same as what we saw earlier. So, how we are defining, these are some random points I have taken. So, here the x coordinate I have put in this list xx, that is 1, 2, 3 up to 20, that is range 1 to 21 will give you 1, 2, 3 up to 20. At 1 the y value is 3, at 2 y value is 3.2, at 3 y value is 4, at 5 y value is 4.2, and so on. So, that is stored in list yy, and then you are looking at this data which you make a tuple, and so xi yi, I going from 1 to 0 to 20 because there are 20 points. You could have also defined this as data is equal to, there is another way of doing, you can simply say zip xx comma yy. So, data equal to zip xs comma yi, and then you can just plot this set of points. That is another way of creating this list of points, right. Now, let us define the error term, some of the error term. So, this is the error, which is the vertical distance of yi from the of xi yi from this point on the straight line, and then define the sum of the error squares, and then the function looks like this. This is quite big because it has written all these sum of the squares of the distance of all these 20 points. Now, what we need to do in order to minimize this function, we need to find the critical points. That is same as saying find the partial derivative of this function f with respect to m and c, and then solve these two equations simultaneously for m and c. So, that is what is done here, first order partial derivative of f with respect to m, this is with respect to c, and then solve this with solution dictionary equal to true enabled. So, in this case, let us see what the solution we get. We should get only one solution because this is the quadratic function. So, yeah, it has only one solution, the m is equal to this. So, let us plot the best fit straight line along with the set of points. So, this is already we did, this is a set of points, and this p is the straight line, that is y is equal to mx plus c. So, it is this is the value of m which is extracted from this solution dictionary, and this is the value of c which is again extracted from this solution dictionary, and then plot these two together. So, when we execute, this is what we get. So, that is the best fit straight line that fits into this set of points. Now, suppose if you add some more points in this and then try to find out. So, for example, let me just add some more points. So, let us say instead of 21, let us make it let us add one more point, let us say this is 22, and in this case 7, I will put for example let us say 2.1, this is 2.1, and this in this case it will be 21. So, that is the set of points. So, one extra point which is plotted, this is the extra point which is given, and as a result now you will, so in this case I have to have this is 21, this is 21. So, Next, let us solve this function value. You can see here it has changed now the solution, and this is now 21. No, this is 20. This is the point size. That's fine. This is not. Yeah. So now you can see here this things have changed. So you can have as many points as you want. Right. But you can also find this Hessian of f at this m and c. So that is the Hessian, and this is actually independent of m and c, because this is a quadratic. So Hessian will be a constant, all the second order partial derivative will be constant. So this is the Hessian, and you can see here this is positive definite. You can check whether this is positive definite using inbuilt function, or this is the determinant which is positive, and this first term here is also positive. So this is a positive definite, therefore this point m and c which we have obtained, that is a local minimum. In fact, this is a global minimum, because this is the quadratic, only one critical point is there. But Sage also provides you an inbuilt function to do this fitting. So how do we do that? So again, let us declare m and c as variables, and let declare a model which you want to fit. So here m times t plus c, we could have written mx plus c, and then used a function called find underscore fit, and give the data, and then give the model which you want to fit, and this is the solution dictionary equal to true. So solution will be printed inside a dictionary, and then this is to show what are these. So let me just one second, let me just first show you this part. So this is the solution, the m is equal to this value and c is equal to this value. Now we can plot all these things. So store the first value in m, and the second value that is in C, in C, and then this is a set of points, and then the plotting the line, and then plot the entire thing. So that's the how. That is again, we have found the best fit line using inbuilt function. Okay. So again, you can even look at this the function find best fit, take the help on this, and then see how it has been defined. You can look at the source code. So now let us look at how to fit a parabola y is equal to a t square plus b t plus c to again the set of given set of points as we have done earlier. So again, let us just take the same set of points. I am just taking the 20 points, I am not adding the last point. So and then these are the set of points. Now let us declare a, b, c as variables and define the sum of the error square as a function of a, b and c. So that is the, and then let us find the first order partial derivatives of this, and then solve for a, b, c. This is the solution you get, a equal to this value, b equal to this value, and c equal to this value. And then let us try to plot the set of points along with the fitted parabola. So here this is the value of a which we have obtained from this solution dictionary. This is value of b, this is value of c, and then we plot the set of points along with the fitted parabola. So this is how it looks like. Again, you can see here in both these cases the value are exactly the same, whether right. And again, you can use inbuilt function, for example find fit. So in this case you only need to change the model fit, and you can just repeat the same code what we have done earlier. So model fit is equal to a t square plus b t plus c, and then find the fit this model to this given data, and then plot all these things together. This is what you get. So again, you can see that these values will be same as what we obtained using the calculus, that is using local maximum, local minima. And of course, if you want to save this figure, you can, one way is you can right click and save, other one is you can use save command, p2.save. So p2 is this variable in which we have saved this, saved we have stored this plot, and then you can say p2.save the least square quad.png. So you can save it in png format, you can save it in pdf format, and it will save in your default working directory, you can find out. Okay. Let us look at another problem. Now this is a problem of fitting, let us say z is equal to ax plus by plus c, this is a plane, to the set of points in the space. As an example, let us look at a problem. Suppose you have interest rate, these are the interest rates as a list, and this is the unemployment rates, and then the stock price in thousands. So this is the stock price. So the stock price, let us say it depends linearly on interest rate and unemployment rate. So we want to estimate what kind of relation it will have. So we want to estimate what should be value of A, B and C, which will be best fit to this given set of data points. So first let us store these values, interest rate in, let us say, XX, unemployment rate in YY, and this stock prices in ZZ. So we have taken the copy of this. I have already explained what is meaning of copy in Python and what is its advantage over just writing XX equal to interest underscore rate, right. So let us store this, and now we can create this data using zip. Just a second, I think we did not run this. Yeah, so let me run this and then create the data and then plot this data. So this is the set of points in the space, and to this set of points you want to fit the best fit plane. So earlier in two variable we were looking at best fit straight line, and this can be generalized to best fit plane in three variables, right. So now what we do, again we define the vertical distance. So that's the vertical distance of the point xi, yi, zi from the plane ax plus by plus cz, and then take the sum of the error square. That will be a function of three variables a, b and c, and once you have done this, then find the partial derivative with respect to a, b and c and solve for a, b, c. Solve these three for a, b, c. So these are the value you are getting, and once you can find out Hessian of this, so that's again Hessian will be a constant. So it, and you can check that this is positive definite. For example, let us store this in H is equal to this and check whether H dot is underscore positive definite. This is again the, you have to change the ring. This says that it is in symbolic ring. So first we will define h is equal to h dot change ring, and then we will make it rdf, and then this is true. And again you can plot the set of points along with the fitted plane. So the plane fitted is this is the a value ax plus by plus c, and to this given set of points. So that's the plane which is the best fit plane to this given set of points. Now you could extend this to let us say points defined in more higher dimension, right. Okay, so let me just leave you with some practice exercises that is fairly straightforward one. So you want to fit a quadratic to this seven given set of points and the best fit straight line to this set of points. Thank you very much.